XFM News. On point.
My name is Barbara Nyamwiza. Welcome to the news in English here at XFM. The executive director of Uganda Young Positives, Koraish Mubiru, has warned the youth against reckless behavior that exposes them to HIV/AIDS. Mubiru told XFM that the COVID-19 lockdown has hit the income of people working in the informal sector, and many young people have started cross-generational relationships and others are engaging in commercial sex, which risks their lives. He advises young people to start small businesses to improve their livelihoods, and this can be done instead of exposing themselves to HIV/AIDS.
Let's restrain ourselves from getting into activities that may cause the risk of spreading HIV. We know that our ways of life have changed, but we can do the things that are within our reach to make sure that we earn a living. For us as Uganda Young Positives, we are implementing the Giving Hope project, where we are revamping these small-scale businesses of our own that were affected during the COVID-19 lockdown. We believe that through doing this, we'll be mitigating the risks of, you know, contracting and spreading HIV amongst young people living with HIV in the informal sector.
Koraish Mubiru is the executive director at Uganda Young Positives. Kampala Lord Mayor contestant Innocent Kawoya has challenged the Kampala city leadership to empower people living with disabilities working in the city. As the world commemorates the International Day of the People with Disabilities, Kawoya says that it is time for the KCCA authority to support people with disabilities to improve their livelihoods.
It's quite challenging that as we celebrate the International Day of the Disabled Persons, very many in Kampala are still so disadvantaged in many ways. Some to the extent that there are many facilities that have been provisioned and provided by government, but those that were chosen to be leaders in the city actually never take the initiative to see those that need them make good use of them.
Meanwhile, Kawoya has promised to support people with disabilities through giving them tax waivers if voted into power.
Part of the agenda as Kawoya for Kampala campaign is to make sure that we bring back everything that belongs to the disabled person. We make sure the markets are in the right place. We make sure they are worked on and developed in a way that helps everyone that is disabled to efficiently work. And we make sure we put up policies that help them not pay so much of taxes and duties in the city.
On to sports now. Express Football Club has signed Riders Lounge as the club official event partner ahead of the new season that kicks off today with KCCA travelling to Bright Stars at Kavumba. Both the club and the lounge have agreed to a one-year partnership where the club will be hosting all events at all Riders Lounge branches across the country. Express FC's senior administrator Patricia Ayebari welcomes the timely partnership, saying it is a sign of club progress in their side.
Our partnership with Riders is to create a win-win situation for both entities, understanding sport in this case, which is football, and appreciating it since we all know what it is carrying. We are one of the oldest clubs in this country, and we believe that through this partnership, you'll be seeing very many things together. This partnership is very vital and important for clubs because without them, the club cannot survive on managing everything on its own.
Patricia Ayebari is an administrator at Express FC. And finally, this afternoon, record high COVID infections and hospitalizations have been reported in the US, with fears they will not slow in the run-up to Christmas. The number of people in hospital passed 100,000 for the first time, a figure that has doubled since early November. New cases rose by a record 19,000 on Wednesday, and the daily death toll of 2,733 was close to a new high of 195,695. The city of Los Angeles has reacted to an unprecedented surge there by ordering residents to stay at home. Nationwide infections are now closing in on 14 million, with more than 264,000 deaths, according to data from the COVID tracking project. My name is Barbara Nyamwiza. Stay tuned to XFM.
XFM News. On point.